Hi, my name is John. Today we shall learn finite and non-finite clauses. Finite clause means the clause which has finite verb and shows the tense of that clause, and non-finite clause is the clause that doesn't have the tense marker and which doesn't show the tense of the sentence. Let us see these two examples and understand what is a finite and what is non-finite clause. First example, Wangari led the movement. Here you can find a tense marker. Here it is in V2, so the tense of the sentence is simple past. Let us see the next sentence. She won the Nobel Prize. Won is also is in V2, so the sentence is in simple past. This led and won are called tense markers. These are called tense markers. So by this tense marker we can understand that it is in simple past. Both the sentences are in simple past. Let us join these two sentences and make a single sentence. Leading the movement, Wangari won the Nobel Prize. Leading the movement. Here, this is called non-finite verb. Non-finite verb. Because leading doesn't show any verb, any tense of that clause. This is called non-finite clause. This is non-finite verb and this is non-finite clause. This is finite clause. Why it is finite clause? It shows the tense of that sentence. This is in simple past. So this tense marker shows the tense of the sentence. So this sentence consists of two clauses. One is non-finite clause and this is finite clause. Why it is non-finite clause? Because this verb doesn't show any tense. Suppose we can write this sentence like this. I will make it in future tense. Leading the movement, Wangari will win the Nobel Prize. Wangari will win the Nobel Prize. So now the sentence becomes simple future. I can make it in simple present also. Wangari wins the Nobel Prize. It doesn't happen, but in a hypothetical case, she repeatedly wins the Nobel Prize, then you can say like this. Leading the movement, Wangari wins the Nobel Prize. So the non-finite clause depends on finite clause to identify itself, which tense it belongs to. Here we have a table which shows present participle and perfect participle. This is active voice, this is passive voice. What is participle? Participle is a word, partially denotes a verb and partially denotes an adjective. So this participle can be called as verbal adjective. Now this sentence is in active voice. So we wrote like this, present participle, leading the movement, Wangari won the Nobel Prize. Leading the movement, Wangari won the Nobel Prize. Suppose if you want to write it in perfect participle, having led the movement, Wangari won the Nobel Prize. Suppose the same sentence could be in passive voice, like the movement was led by Wangari, she won the prize. She won the Nobel Prize. Nobel Prize. Being led the movement, Wangari won the Nobel Prize. Suppose if you want to write the passive voice into perfect participle, having been led the movement, Wangari won the Nobel Prize. For better understanding, we shall learn more exercises and more sentences from the textbook. Underline the non-finite clauses in the following sentences. Born in London, he became the citizen of the UK. Born in London is present participle, so it's the non-finite clause which doesn't carry any tense marker. Second one, having done his homework, he went out to play. It's a perfect participle. Having done his homework is the non-finite clause. Third one, recognized by his boss, he got an appreciation letter. Recognized by his boss is the non-finite clause, which is past participle. Fourth one, encouraged by his father, Ravi got distinction in his final examination. Encouraged by his father, which doesn't carry any tense marker, this is also past participle. Encouraged by his father is non-finite clause. Next one, with the tree grown tall, we get more shade. It's a general phenomena that with the tree grown tall is the non-finite clause here. We get more shade. Yes, as the tree grow tall, we get more shade. Next one, we left the room and went home to search for the books. We left indicates past form, and went also indicate past form. Home to search for the books. To search for the books does not carry any tense marker, which doesn't have any auxiliary verb, helping verb. To search for the books is the non-finite clause here. Next one, do we have the money to buy that car? Here, to buy that car is the non-finite clause, because after infinity 2, there is no auxiliary verb, so which does not indicate any tense. To buy that car is the non-finite clause. Next, we were not able to get away until now. Here in the sentence, to get away until now is the non-finite clause. After infinity 2, there is no auxiliary verb. So, to get away until now is the non-finite clause here. Last but one, having read the book, I returned it to the library. Having read the book is the non-finite clause, perfect participle. Last one, jumping on his horse, the farmer rode to the market. Jumping on his horse, which does not have any tense marker, so it is non-finite clause, jumping on his horse. Examination point of view, we have to learn present participle and perfect participle. The question will be given like this. He was born in London. He became the citizen of the UK. Rewrite the sentence using non-finite clause. So, born in London, he became the citizen of UK. Second one, he has done his homework. he went out to play. Combine the sentence beginning with having. Write in perfect participle. Having done his homework, he went out to play. Third one, he was recognized by his boss. He got an appreciation letter. Write in past participle. Recognized by his boss, he got an appreciation letter. So like this, we can write in present participle and perfect participle. Thank you for watching. Please do subscribe and share this video.